I am going to force you to sit through a micro history lesson of the Grand Canyon Railroad. My name's Todd. I am the owner of Todd's Amazing Tours, and we've been at these private tours for about 3 years now. So we've had a lot of guests, oh, thousands. And when you start having that many guests for that long, you start getting return guests. Thank you. If you're one of them, thank you, thank you, thank you. Well, a lot of people want to do the Grand Canyon tour. Maybe there's somebody else that's part of their group, but they don't want to do exactly the same thing they did before, even though it was a blast. So they want to incorporate something new. And one of the things that I'm getting feedback on is the Grand Canyon Railroad. Now, a little history, like I promised, on the Grand Canyon Railroad. It was established in 1901. So that's when they put the spur line up to the south rim of the Grand Canyon, which is now the National Park. They built the El Tovar Hotel, the railroad did. They had a very huge hand in that because they wanted to build a nice hotel there so they could get the customers from the East Coast, the affluent ones, to buy the railway ticket to go all the way out to this exotic destination and spend money once they got there at the hotel. Well, now, of course, it's different. The railway is owned by a private company and they have like a little depot and stuff there. So it is a really cool experience. So how do you incorporate that? Well, it's 3 hours from the valley, the Phoenix Valley, Scottsdale, Peoria, wherever you might be staying, roughly to Williams, where the depot is, where the train leaves. So we're going to have to move back the departure date a little bit, or time a little bit. Instead of 7 a.m., we're going to depart at 6 a.m. That gives us about 3 hours to get to the depot, get there about 9 a.m. You can kind of look around, buy some food, some snacks and stuff before you board the train. Then you're going to board the train, take part in that, which is awesome, super fun. You'll get to the actual national park. You'll get off the train there. You'll explore the village a little bit. While you're traveling on the train, your guide's going to jump in the car that took you to Williams and is going to meet you inside the park. That way, you're not sacrificing anything of the ground tour. So if you can imagine, instead of driving in by car from Williams, which is about an hour, you're going to spend about 2.5 hours on the train. We're going to pick you up and we're going to stuff in as many cool custom stops as we can before we leave at 4 p.m. So the departure time stays the same, gets you back to the valley around 7:30, 8 o'clock, depending on how many times we stop on the way back. And so the day doesn't really get that much longer other than the additional hour in the morning in the car, just so we can catch that train at 9:30. If you have questions, of course, call me. I think this is going to be a super popular add-on. The drive to Williams, even if you have a rental car in the valley, it's still a bit of a drive. And then, of course, how do you do that? I mean, you would have to do the round trip into the park by train because you'd have to park your car at the depot. You're not going to have the convenience of one of our guides meeting you there and kind of starting the custom tour from there. You're going to be stuck to just kind of what everybody else is stuck doing inside the park. And then getting back on the train, coming back to the depot, spending the time back on the train, and then getting back in your car and driving home. So this is really a way of combining our custom tour with a super cool train ride as well.